Hello students, let us continue the session on revision in the chapter fractions and decimals. In the previous session we learnt till question 6. Question number 6 is, which of the following is not equal to the others? Here I can reduce these fractions if I divide this fraction by numerator and denominator by 2, I'll be getting 3 by 4. This one I will divide by 4, it becomes 3 by 4. This one I'll divide by 5, it becomes 3 by 5. This one I'll divide by 6, it becomes 3 by 4. If you look at option A, B and D, they are equal to 3 by 4. Only in the option C, we have 3 by 5. So this number is not equal to the others. Rest all are equivalent. Question 7. Which of the following fractions is greatest? So I need to identify which one is greater among these. You observe both numerator and denominator. Here all numerators are 5. So we need to compare only the denominator. The greater the denominator, the smaller will be the value. So here smaller denominator is 6. Therefore, the greatest fraction is option B, 5 by 6. Question 8. Which of the following fractions are the smallest? You'll compare again the numerators and the denominators. Here, all denominators are 8. So, smaller the numerator will have smaller value. Smaller numerator here is 3. Therefore, the smallest fraction is option C, 3 by 8. Question number 9. Sum of 4 by 17 and 15 by 17 is, if you look at the denominators are same, so the denominator will be retained as it is, only the sum of the numerators is found. 4 plus 15 is 19. 19 by 17 is there in option A. So the right answer is option A, 19 by 17. Question number 10. On subtracting 5 by 9 and 19 by 9, the result is, so we need to subtract the smaller number from the larger. Since the denominators are same, the smaller number is 5 by 9. So from the larger number, I need to subtract the smaller number. So 19 minus 5 will be 14 by 9. This is present in option B. So the right answer is option B, 14 by 9. 0.7499 lies between. It lies between 0.749 and 0.75. Because 0.7499 is successor of 0.749 and predecessor of 0.75. Question number 12. 0.023 lies between. You observe all the options here, you will get to know that it lies between 0.02 and 0.03. This is by mere observation. 0.023 is next number after the 0.021 and 22, and it is less than 0.03. So the right answer for the question is option B, 0.02 and 0.03. 11 by 7 can be expressed in the form. Here, if you divide this 11 by 7, 11 one time is 7, 1 time is 7, the remainder becomes 4. It can be written as 1 4 by 7. And this option is present in option C. So the right answer for the question is option C, 1 4 by 7. Question number 14, the mixed fraction 5 4 by 7 can be expressed as. So we have learned a method, this 5 should be multiplied to 7 plus 4 should be added by keeping the same denominator. It becomes 35 plus 4 by 7, which is 39 by 4, and it is there in option D. So the right answer is option D, 39 upon 4. Next, 15th one, 0.07 plus 0.008 is equal to. We got to add them. Best thing is write the respective decimals one below the other. On addition, it becomes 870.0, so it becomes 0.078, which is there in option C. So the answer is option C, 0.078. Which of the following decimals is the greatest? Firstly, converting the given decimals in like decimals, we get 0.1820, 0.0925, 0.2900, 0.0380. These are the numbers when expressed in like decimals. So number of decimal places we have made it as same. Now observe the place values. Here 0.2900 is a larger number because the 10th place is 2. Therefore, the greatest among these is option C. Answer is option C, 0.29. 17th one, which of the following decimals is the smallest? Here again we need to write them as like decimals. There are 3 maximum decimal places. So 0.270, 0.082, 103, and 1.500. If you observe very carefully, the smallest one is 0.082. This is the smallest one that's there in option C. So the right answer is option C, 0.082. Question number 18, 13.572, correct to its the 10th place is. We have learned how to express the given number in a estimated way. Here 7 is a larger number compared to 5, so it will be added up, so 13.6 it becomes. So the right answer is ऑप्शन डी 13.6। नाउ 15.8 माइनस 6.73 इज इक्वल टू, आई नीड टू राइट दिस 15.80 एंड 6.73, देन सब्ट्रैक्ट। सो 10 माइनस 3 विल बी 7, 7 माइनस 7 इज 0, 15 माइनस 6 इज 9, सो 9.07, 9.07 इज देयर इन ऑप्शन बी, सो द राइट आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी 9.07। 20th क्वेश्चन, द डेसिमल 0.238 इज इक्वल टू द फ्रैक्शन, so I need to divide this 0.238 as 238 upon 1000. Now if I consider divided by 2, I'll be getting 119 upon 500. So this is present in option A, so the right answer is option A, 119 upon 500. Now we have the questions which are fill in the blank type. 21st, a number representing a part of a dash is called fraction. So we know the answer, it is a part of a whole. A fraction with a denominator greater than the numerator is called as proper fraction. Fraction with the same denominator are called as like fractions. 13 integer 5 by 18 is a dash fraction. It's an improper fraction. Here it should be an improper fraction. 18 by 5 is mixed fraction. I made a mistake here. Here we have integer as well as proper fraction. It's a combination. So the right answer is mixed fraction. For this one, it is improper. 7 is smaller than 19, so it is a proper fraction. Look at 5 by 8 and 3 by 8, they have the same denominator, so they are like fractions, like proper fractions. Next one, 28, 6 upon 11 and 6 by 13 are dash, they are unlike, they have the different denominators, so they are unlike. The fraction 6 by 15 in the simplest form is, if I consider 6 divided by 3 and 15 divided by 3, both are divisible by 3, so it becomes 2 by 5, and the answer is 2 by 5. 17 by 34 in the simplest form is, 17 as well as 34 are divisible by 17, when I divide, I get 1 upon 2, so 1 by 2. 18 by 135, 90 by 675 are proper, unlike, and dash fractions. Here, they are proper, they are also unlike, but then when you do this into 5, we get the same values, so they are equivalent fractions. It is because 18 5 times is 90, 135 5 times is 675. 32nd, 8 2 by 7 is equal to the improper fraction, 8 7s are 56 plus 2 is 58 upon 7. 87 by 7 is equal to the mixed fraction, so I need to divide this 87. So 7 12 times is 84, 3 will remain, so 12, 3 by 7, so 12, 3 by 7 is the mixed fraction. Next one, 9 plus 0, 2 by 10 plus 6 by 100 in the decimal will be equal to, this is nothing but 9, this one will be 0.2 plus 0.06, add them up, we get 9.26, so it is 9.26. 35th one, the decimal 16.25 is equal to the fraction. This should be written as 16.25 by 100. So further we can simplify this. They are divisible by 25. When they are divisible by 25, we get 1625 by 25 divided by 100 by 25. This will be 65 by 4. We can express in a mixed fraction 16 1 by 4. The fraction 7 by 25 is equal to the decimal number 0.28. The reason is 7 by 25 I'll multiply with 4, I get 28 by 100, which is 0.28. Now it's a question related to addition. 9 will be there in the denominator, in the numerator the numbers will be added up, we get 58 upon 9, so answer is 58 by 9. In the next one, we need to subtract. So 14 will be the LCM, 67 minus 24 will become 43 by 14. So the right answer, 43 by 14. Now it's a addition, 17 by 2 plus this mixed fraction, I'll write as improper one. It becomes 7 by 2, so 17 plus 7 is 24 by 2, which is 12. So the answer is 12. 9, 1 by 4, it is 37 by 4, minus 5 by 4, it becomes 32 by 4, which is 8. This is a direct addition. 5 plus 3 is 8, 7 plus 5 is 12, so 1 is carry, 10 plus 4 is 14, 14.28. Next is a subtraction, 16 minus 8 will be 8, 6 minus 6 will be 0, then 8 minus 2 is 66.08. Next, 43rd, the value of 50 coins of 50 paise is equal to rupees. If there are 50 coins and the value is 50 paise, so when I multiply them, I get 25 followed by 2 zeros paise. I'll convert this into rupees now. It is rupees 2500 upon 100. It becomes rupees 25. So the answer is rupees 25. 3/100 plus 3/10 will be equal to 3/100 is 3 by 100 plus 3/10 is 3 by 10. So it becomes 0.03 plus 0.3. 0.33. With this, I'll end today's session. We shall take up the next set of questions in the next session. Thank you.